Hi there! So here we are. It's January 2021 and I'm thinking of what model I should build next. It's definitely 2021 and not at all a newly recorded intro. I came across a picture of the Strv 105. It is a Centurion, but upgraded with infrared sight and new suspension. Sounds interesting, especially since I'm currently aiming at Cold War vehicles. The only issue is, it's going to be huge in 1:6 scale. Will it be possible to build a model that large using 3D printed parts? Let's fire up the printer, grab some plywood, and find out.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. So, as some of you might have noticed, I accidentally used the wrong color for one of the camouflage patterns. Instead of the light green that is common on modern Swedish tanks and infantry vehicles, I used a brownish, older version of color. So the background of the 105 is that it was a prototype vehicle, one was made, and it was a test to see if you could upgrade the Centurions one more time, with new suspension, engine, gearbox, and also an infrared sight. Of course, that didn't happen since we leased the Leopard 2 from Germany. So the idea with this model is that it's a sort of what-if model. What if we actually used the 105 in the organization? The Swedish Army would have had both the Stridsvagn 122, the Leopard 2s, as well as the Stridsvagn 105, the Centurion. And in that case, the 105 would get the same three-tone camouflage as the Stridsvagn 122 uses today, which is a black, a dark green, and a lighter green. So I have to repaint the brown parts of the camouflage. And we're leaving for Denmark tomorrow. So what I did was I found the RAL code for the Tamiya light green, the XF5. And I went to my local paint shop and asked them if they could mix it for me. So no time to waste, let's continue.
Thank you.